Unveil a forgotten chapter of history that still echoes today. Step into a world where one man's resilience met the darkest of circumstances. In a time of oppression, his story emerges. A black slave compelled to share his body and soul with countless slave women. Yet, the haunting question remains. What drove him to relinquish his body to such torment? Join us as we uncover this story of a slave that was forced to sleep with hundreds of slave women. Hailing from Sorocaba, Sao Paulo, Pata Seca transcended his name, becoming a symbol that etched his fate in stone. Envision yourself standing by his side, dwarfed by his staggering height of 7 feet 2 inches, an awe-inspiring physical presence that foretold an enigmatic destiny. His towering stature cast him as the chosen instrument, thrust into an eerie role, that of a breeder, a vessel manipulated for the sinister machinations of others. This narrative unfurls a vivid tapestry, weaving a life ensnared within the labyrinthine corridors of history, a heart-rending reminder of the abyss humanity can plunge into when power remains unchecked. In the shadow of his tale, we glimpse the raw and often chilling complexities of existence, serving as a poignant reflection of both the frailty and fortitude that define our shared journey through time. In the early days of January 1808, a pivotal shift rippled across the vast expanse of the United States and the Caribbean, forever altering the course of history. The relentless flow of Africans into the lands as enslaved individuals came to a resolute halt. But this cessation was far from a mere end. It was the precipice of an unprecedented transformation that would shape nations, economies, and lives in profound ways. The slaves, tragic pawns in this sprawling tapestry, were regarded as commodities, akin to livestock, by both the proprietors and the traders. Their bodies were the crucible that nurtured the production of these coveted cash crops, weaving an intricate web that fueled the triangular trade. Yet, with the closure of the transatlantic slave trade and the ghastly specter of mortality haunting these beleaguered souls due to their torturous labor, the reservoir of enslaved individuals began to run perilously dry. Amid this distressing scarcity, the slaveholders found themselves at an impasse. Their dominion hinged upon a desperate need for labor. Bound by necessity, they sought an alternative, a sinister solution that could only be conceived within a mindset that saw human beings as tradable commodities, bereft of agency or rights. The concept birthed from these chilling depths was one that echoed with sinister connotations, the breeding of slaves. This is where our story finds its tragic hero, Pata Seca. In the sprawling tapestry of history, his name would echo as both a testament to resilience and a reminder of unfathomable horrors. Pata Seca emerged from the shadows, a man born of strife and suffering, a figure who would come to father a multitude of offspring, shaping a lineage that would come to constitute a village in itself. As we traverse the annals of history, we find ourselves transported to the Caribbean, a realm where enslaved men toiled with a singular purpose: to sire the next generation of slaves. It is within this realm that the narrative of Pata Seca unfolds, his life inextricably intertwined with the mechanisms of a grim industry. In the midst of an enveloping darkness that seemed to shroud his very existence, Pata Seca's life unfolded with an extraordinary twist of fate that defied the norms of his circumstances. While his fellow brethren labored ceaselessly amidst the fields, Pata Seca's journey took an unexpected turn, bestowing upon him a distinct and curious position within the confines of his captivity. Emerging as a sentinel of unconventional privileges, he assumed the roles of a messenger, an animal caretaker, and a wanderer bridging the realms between a rustic village and the bustling urban tapestry of Sao Carlos. In a world where fate weaves its tapestry with both cruelty and resilience, Pata Seca's life unfolds as a haunting tale of divergence. But as his uniqueness places him in a position of favor, an unsettling question emerges. How could such favor become his most sinister curse? Watch till the end to find out. Nevertheless, the cruel caprices of his captors would unfurl a new, malevolent destiny for Pata Seca, one etched with a sinister role that cast him into the loathsome vocation of a slave breeder. Within the chilling machinations of his overseer's mind, Pata Seca's towering stature and exceptional attributes designated him as an ideal instrument to perpetuate the harrowing cycle of enslavement through coerced reproduction. His very essence became a systematically leveraged means to an uncompromising end. a mere tool deployed in the relentless pursuit of an exploitative workforce. Stripped of personal agency, his body became a pawn of genetic worth, manipulated to engage in unions with enslaved women, birthing a fresh generation bound to the grueling cycle of servitude. Pataseka's legacy is shadowed by an enduring lament, his progeny thrust into a destiny marred by anguish. These innocent lives, thrust prematurely into a realm of toil and suffering, bore the indelible marks of a cruel system that relegated them to mere property. Bereft of the joys inherent to a carefree childhood, devoid of autonomy, and subjected to unfathomable brutalities, they wrestled with the very essence of their humanity. Their paths were woven with the threads of sorrow and marked by the scars of a merciless institution that treated them as commodities rather than sentient beings. In the heart of this somber narrative, the radiant spark of Pataseka's resilience flickers, a testament to the power of the human spirit to endure and transcend the gravest of circumstances. His story resonates as a poignant reminder of the complex interplay between destiny and agency, a tapestry where individuals like Pataseka grapple with the profound questions of identity, autonomy, and the relentless pursuit of humanity's inherent dignity. With the final shattering of enslavement's shackles, Pataseka embarked on an odyssey that intricately wove threads of love and companionship into the very fabric of his newfound liberty. It was within the warm embrace of Palmyra that his heart discovered a haven, a sanctuary that became the cornerstone of his existence. United in the sacred bonds of matrimony, they found themselves blessed by the laughter and joy of 9 precious children, a testament to the radiant resilience of a family birthed from the ashes of oppression. Across the sprawling canvas of land bequeathed by a former master, Pataseka wielded the brush of hope and renewal. With unwavering determination, he chiseled a destiny akin to that of a virtuoso, creating a masterpiece called Sitio Pataseka, a realm where the very earth yielded its bountiful treasures. His calloused hands, forged in the crucible of labor, lovingly crafted rapadura, an unrefined sugar that stood as a monument to his sweat and perseverance. The proceeds, though modest in nature, flowed like a vital current, not just nurturing crops, but also nurturing dreams of a future untainted by the looming shadows of the past. Yet, as life's tapestry unfurled, its capricious whims wielded a cruel brushstroke that altered destiny's course. In an almost trivial turn of fate, a mere nail beneath a single step, the venomous specter of tetanus encroached upon Pataseka's vibrant spirit. Despite the earnest ministrations of a local healer, the march of fate proved relentless. In the hushed embrace of February 1958, a mere whisper amidst the winds of time, Pataseka's indomitable journey found its end, leaving behind a legacy that still bloomed in its vibrant fragility. Embedded in the chronicles of time, Pataseka's closing days elevated him to the esteemed role of the city's revered patriarch, who just months earlier had led a jubilant birthday procession. A somber reminder that life's most triumphant peaks often transition into poignant swan songs. His narrative weaves the tapestry of endurance, seamlessly entwined with his very essence, reflecting the unyielding resolve of countless Africans ensnared in the shadows of Brazilian enslavement. His odyssey acts as a gateway, not only unveiling the distressing tragedy woven into his existence, but also spotlighting the remarkable spirit that steered generations through the harshest eras. A tribute to tenacity, his legacy stands as a testament to the unbreakable strength that blooms even in the harshest crucible of human experience. A tribute to resilience, his legacy stands as an unwavering testament to the strength that germinates and flourishes within the harshest of soils. In tracing the indelible marks of Pataseka's path, we come to recognize the echoes of history, reminding us that while shadows may cloak the past, the light of endurance can pierce even the darkest veils, illuminating the strength that resides within the human spirit.